Welcome to this new video programme. Containing scenes taken from films in the Rails Around series, we will show the area to the west of Birmingham. Outside London, Birmingham New Street is the natural centre of the rail network, with lines radiating in all directions. At the time of filming, the station was handling 650 trains per day. From the western end of New Street, two main lines emerge. One is the Stour Valley line to Wolverhampton, and the other is the West Suburban line, which makes a junction with the freight line from Saltley at King's Norton. This is known as the Birmingham and Gloucester line.
Thank you.
Yard Green is located near the summit of the Lickey Bank. Bromsgrove, we can see 6V14 with empty acid tanks for Bagland Bay. Worcester Shrub Hill was opened on the 5th of October 1850 and became a joint Great Western and Midlands station. This train will use the Cotswold line to Oxford. 6V27 consists of empties from Longbridge to Swindon. Cheltenham was opened on the 24th of June 1840 by the Birmingham and Gloucester Railway. A feature of this line was that it tried to avoid towns, but the citizens of Cheltenham protested and a compromise was made. The station is still a fair distance from the town centre. At Gloucester, the broad gauge Great Western Railway met the standard gauge Midland Railway.
Bristol and Stroud, Kemble and Swindon. Change to Swindon, the Didcot Parkway, Reading and London Paddington.
Platforms 1 and 2 combine to make the second longest platform in the country. At 1600 feet, it was built in 1852. B13 is the 0540 from Milford Haven to Westerly. Passenger traffic between Birmingham and Worcester uses the old Oxford, Worcester and Wolverhampton line through Kidderminster and Droitwich Spa. The present line leaves the Stour Valley main line at Smethwick West. You can see where the new link to Galton Bridge and Birmingham Snow Hill is to be made. The signal box has now been demolished. Kidderminster Station was opened on the 1st of May 1852. It is adjacent to Kidderminster Town Station, which is the southern terminus of the Seven Valley Railway. Droitwich Spa station is at the junction of the line from Kidderminster to Worcester and the line to Stoke Works Junction on the Birmingham and Gloucester main line. A number of services avoid Worcester Shrub Hill and proceed to Foregate Street. This station is peculiar in that it actually has two single lines passing through it. The lines join at Henwick Junction to the southwest of the station. Great Malvern was opened in 1860 by the Worcester and Hereford Railway. It has been maintained in a traditional style. Ledbury Station is one of the passing places on the single line from Great Malvern to Hereford. The original station was opened in 1853 by the Shrewsbury and Hereford Joint Railway. It was originally known as Bar's Court. It is situated on the main line between Cardiff and Shrewsbury. For many years, the station was a centre for preserved steam specials and still maintains watering facilities, etc. At Craven Arms we see the single line to South Wales. There are 27 stations between here and Llanelli. This is 6V78, the 325 steel empties from D Marsh to Margam. Before we go into Shrewsbury, we will take a look at another line in the area. The Stour Valley line from Birmingham to Wolverhampton is the last section of the West Midland route of the West Coast Main Line. The new high and low level stations at Galton Bridge. The high level station now provides services between Worcester and Birmingham Snow Hill. The citizens of Wolverhampton were without satisfactory rail transport for many years, as the original main line, the Grand Junction Railway, bypassed the town to the north. Wolverhampton, we connect with the ex-Great Western Main Line, also known as the Didcot and Chester Line. Thank you. The only freight using the line are coal and oil trains for Bridge North Power Station. Once a busy mainline station with engine sheds and large freight facilities, Shrewsbury is now a shadow of what it was. Lines converging are from Hereford, Mid Wales, Chester and Crewe and Wolverhampton. This Class 153 operates a shuttle service between Wrexham's other station, the Central, and Bidston, near Birkenhead. The steel trains from South Wales come onto this branch at Wrexham and make their way to British Steel at Shotton. Thank you. steel train roars over the North Wales coast mainline and heads into Demarsh Yard. We can see a Class 37 hauling a North West train service from Crewe to Holyhead. Chester has managed to remain a busy station. It is also a terminus for Merseyrail Electrics using the Chester and Birkenhead line. Class 37s are used on the numerous Crewe to Bangor and Holyhead services operated by North West Trains. At Houghton, the line from Chester makes a junction with the line to Ellesmere Port, Helsby and Warrington. Thank you. This stabling point provides locos to work the fuel trains out of Stanlow Oil Refinery. At Helsby, the line joins with the Chester and Warrington line. Although originally a London and North Western owned line, the Great Western were granted running rights, and this enabled them to get trains into Manchester. At Mickle Trafford Junction on the Chester and Warrington line, a junction is made with a line to Manchester. This line was operated by the Great Central Railway in the early days. This class 37 has to wait for the passenger service to clear the single line section between here and Mickle Trafford Junction. When the railways were originally constructed, the Birmingham terminus was at Curzon Street. It was here that the London and Birmingham Railway met the Grand Junction line to the northwest. From Proofhouse Junction, the line bends almost 180 degrees through Vauxhall and Aston. At Bescot, it is running almost parallel to the Stour Valley line to Wolverhampton. Most of the freight movements for the area are now concentrated at Bescot. In common with many other towns, Walsall found itself bypassed by the main line and was eventually connected by means of the South Staffordshire Railway. This Class 37 is heading for Castle Bromwich via the freight only line. The line to the left is to Bloxwich and Rugeley. For many years this was one of the very few four-way junctions on the network. The lines to Brownhills and Wentzfield have now disappeared.